But Randy was famous for landing in awkward positions, and you would think that it would kill the ordinary man. And Randy, for some reason, would pop up like it was a 1 meter dive, and was Shake always okay. He had was attempting to qualify in the world's high diving championship that particular year. I remember during that event, Randy coming up to me, and he said to me, "Dana," he goes, "how would you do a 1.5 twisting quad somersault?" And I said, "Well, why?" He goes, "Well, it's my next dive." I go, "It's your next dive, and you don't know how to do it?" He goes, "No, I don't know how to do it." So I go, "Well, here's how I would do it. I would do a full twisting 1.5, and then do a 2.5 over, and do what we call a branny out, which is basically a somersault with a half twist. And by doing it that way, you keep all of your momentum going forward, and you never stop your revolutions." And Randy said, "Oh, hell, that's not the way I'm going to do it. I'm going to do a front triple somersault with a half twist, and then I'm going to do a back somersault with a full twist." And I said, "No, you're not." And he goes, "What do you mean, no, I'm not?" I said, "Randy, when you do that dive, you're going to stop all of your momentum going forward, and when you go to do that back somersault with a full twist, you're going to have no rotation. You're going to land flat on your ass." "Oh, what the hell do you know? I should have never asked." "Well, why did you ask me then? If you didn't want my advice, don't ask me." So Randy goes up to do this 1.5 twisting quad, and he goes for a front triple somersault with a half twist. He goes for the back somersault with a full twist, and you can literally see his arms go for the twist in midair, and nothing. He's completely stopped. And he's got to do what we call a Susie around a corner, which is basically just running, trying to get into the water any way you can without getting killed. And he ends up doing a full twisting 3.5 somersault from 100 feet, which, you know, you couldn't do that dive if you wanted to do that dive. And once again, I run up to the side of the pool, because this is my good buddy, to make sure he's okay. I think he's smoked. I think he broke his neck, or he's got to have busted ribs, or he's got to be in terrible shape. And naturally, Randy pops up, and I go, "You okay?" And he goes, "Yeah, I'm okay." I go, "You sure?" He goes, "Yeah, I'm okay." I go, "Man, you know, why did you ever attempt that?" He goes, "What do you mean?" He goes, "If I had another 50, 60 feet, I would have made that dive." And he goes, "I think I'm going to do it for the world record tomorrow." And I go, "No, you're not going to do it for the world record tomorrow."
And that was from 100 feet, if I remember.
And that was 100 feet, yeah.
So he holds the record for the full twisting 3.5.
Oh, yeah, he holds the world record for the highest full twisting 3.5. But that's how Randy was. You know, he was just a bull of a man, and he was just as stubborn as he was strong. And once Randy had set his mind at doing something, he was going to do it. And he had no fear. That's just how Randy was. You know, I mean, he was a stubborn bastard. And if he was going to go for that, you know, 1.5 twisting quad, he was going to go for that 1.5 twisting quad, even though he didn't even know how to do it. All he did in his mind was picture how he would do it, and was willing and stubborn enough to go do a dive from 100 feet that, you know, would have seriously injured or maybe even killed the ordinary diver. The next day, sure enough, there he was, ready to compete for the world record, and did the dive, and didn't do a real good dive there either, but didn't get hurt. I mean, Randy, for some strange reason, would just, you know, he was just ungodly strong. And
he didn't care.
And he didn't care. Yeah.